from behind.
We'll be right back.
his opponent from Los Angeles, California, weighing in at 241 pounds, Kyle.
Listen to this crowd, guys. They're fired up for this one, as well as they should be. This match has instant classic written all over it. This match will undoubtedly have a big impact on where these guys stand in the next WWE.com power rankings. And there's been so much upward movement from new faces over the past few weeks that dropping more than 10 spots following a loss isn't necessarily out of the question.
There's no other way to put it. This one-on-one match is going to be a struggle in every sense of the word.
side by side. She just said she got to move your body.
contest is scheduled for one fall. And from out of this world, weighing in at 243 pounds, Charlie Azrael.
Plenty of action coming up as we have six of WWE's top names ready to go here.
Oh, man, Michael, six-man matches like this always remind me of World Class back in the 1980s.
Disrespect he shows for his opposition at times is downright awful.
I wouldn't worry too much about it, Michael. One of these nights, somebody's gonna slap that disrespect right out of his mouth. And tonight might just be that night.
Sorry to disturb you this late in the night. I have a serious inquiry directed towards Nickelodeon. My question is,
what the fuck are you doing? You know, y'all used to have some fire bitches, and when I turn on the TV, I'm trying to see my favorite bitches. Zoe 101? Jeanette McCurdy? Oh my god! Oh, and now all you got is these freak teens! Run, I'm not a pedal, I'm not trying to look at these little kids and get aroused. Now I can't watch Nickelodeon with my dick in my hand anymore. Bring all my bitches back. I need all my bitches. I need all my bitches. The new shit you put out is whack. Dan Schneider. I'm just trying to get an erection, but now that these kids look at 13 and under, my penis will suffer. Dan fucking Schneider. This ain't a fucking cake, bitch. I wanna watch a sitcom. Put my hand on my dick. I wanna see a titty, titty. Not fucking dick shit. Return all the objects, or you go get it, bitch.
iCarly, iCarly.
I don't care if you look like Michael Jackson, as long as you giving me action. And Freddy gon' film the reaction. Sam gonna join in and suck me a fat one. Nickelodeon girls. Ariana Grande.
Quite some time.
Yeah, and I'll be interested to see if he maintains that high level of aggression he's been showing of late.
I don't see any reason why he would, Michael. There's no reason to start being amiable now.
Somebody once told me the band was gonna troll me. I ain't the biggest guy on the plane. I was looking kinda dumb with my
feet. From the United States of America, weighing in at 324 pounds. Big.
Well, the sheep starts coming and I don't stop coming. Four. So to the feds and I'm pushing late money.
This is it.
Makes sense to talk about pain. Taking the mask off, you never know if you don't show. You'll never fly if you don't go. Hey, baby, take the mask off. You're a big guy's CIA. Hey, now, who is you guys? Then throw down out on the plane. Bravo, rolling, I love you. You're a big guy.
What do you do here tonight? That's what's so exciting about watching.
Superstars look more than ready to get going here. When I looked at the card for tonight, this one definitely stood out as one you don't want to miss.
Cock and ball torture from Wikipedia, the free encyclopedia at en.wikipedia.org. Cock and ball torture, CBT, is a sexual activity involving torture of the male genitals. This may involve directly painful activities such as wax play, genital spanking, squeezing, ball busting, genital flogging, urethral play, tickle torture, erotic electrostimulation, or even kicking. The recipient of such activities may receive direct physical pleasure via masochism through knowledge that the play is pleasing to a sadistic dominant. Image, electrostimulation applied on a penis. Contents. Section 1. In pornography. Section 2. Ball stretcher. Section 3. Parachute. Section 4. Humbler. Section 5. Testicle cuff. Section 1. In pornography. In addition to its occasional role in BDSM pornography, tamakeri, literally ball kicking, is a separate genre in Japan. One notable actress in tamakeri is Erika Nagai, who typically uses her martial arts skills to knee or kick men in the testicles. Section 2. Ball stretcher. A ball stretcher is a sex toy that is fastened around a man in order to elongate the scrotum and provide a feeling of weight pulling the testicles away from the body. While leather stretchers are most common, other models are made of steel rings that are fastened with screws, causing additional, mildly uncomfortable weight to the wearer. The length of the stretcher may vary from 1 to 4 inches, and the steel models can weigh as much as 5 pounds. Section 3. Parachute. A parachute is a small collar, usually made from leather, which fastens around the scrotum, and from which weights can be hung. Conical in shape, with 3 or 4 short chains hanging beneath, which weight can be applied. Used as part of cock and ball torture within a BDSM relationship, the parachute provides a constant drag and squeezing effect on the man's testicles. Moderate weights of 3 to 5 kilograms can be suspended, especially during bondage. Smaller weights can be used when the man is free to move, when the swinging effect of the weight can restrict sudden movements, as well as providing a visual stimulus for the dominant partner. Section 4. Humbler. A humbler is a BDSM physical restraint device used to restrict restrict the movement of a submissive male partner in a BDSM scene. The humbler consists of a testicle cuff device that clamps around the base of the scrotum, mounted in the center of a bar that passes behind the thighs at the base of the buttocks. This forces the wearer to keep his legs forward, as any attempt to straighten legs even slightly pulls directly on the scrotum, causing considerable discomfort to extreme pain. Section 5. Testicle cuff. A testicle cuff is a ring-shaped device around the scrotum between the body and the testicle.
Let's get this thing going. If you haven't hit record yet, now might be a good time to do that. These guys are going to have a match you'll want to watch over and over again.
Ouch. What a clothesline!
Good grief.
He just cannot be caught.
We'll be right back.
Well, it's a big show.
Tonight, baby.
Oh, yeah.
in my eyes. When you look at me, they are so gorgeous, they'll set you free. Could it be my walk, or just my stare, that makes you freeze when I appear? Super good looking, every hair in place, everyone loves this gorgeous face. You can't deny my beauty shot on everything that you are not. Part man, but all model. Am I what you want? Am I who you follow? Don't try and fight it. You can't deny.
Velveteen Dream.
Thank you. Somebody once told me the band is gonna
try. This should be an incredible.
Well, it's a big show.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from England, weighing in at 535 pounds, Cameron England.
Get ready, guys. Big time singles matches coming up here.
And I can assure you these two superstars have been waiting all day to get their hands on each other.
I'd like to point out just how focused these guys look here tonight.
They really do, Michael, which makes me think we're in for one heck of a match here tonight.
They just know they're so sure that England's gonna blow it away, gonna blow it away. But I know they can play, cause I remember.
Welcome all my honored guests.
And his opponent from Japan, weighing in at 252 pounds.
The atmosphere inside this arena for this one is absolutely insane, guys.
And if you think this is insane, just wait until this thing kicks into high gear. You ain't seen nothing yet.
The only way for personal issues to be ultimately resolved is two superstars enter the squared circle and go one-on-one in a good old-fashioned wrestling match.
And we're live from the heart of New York City.
I'm just glad Mung and I made it to the arena. We had a few minutes in the last night. Did you know you're not supposed to ride the bull on Wall Street?
Abdominal stretch. It's locked in.
This is a great win.
Not so fast.
to do?
Yeah.
You think you could tell us what to win? You think you better?
Yeah.
Well, you better get ready to bow to the master.
Introducing the challenger, from no place in particular, weighing in at 246 pounds, Jones. And introducing the champion, from the United States of America, weighing in at 241 pounds, he is the Intercontinental Champion, Rapparaz.
Who's going to lay claim to the workhorse title here tonight? Workhorse title here tonight.
The Intercontinental Championship held by over a dozen WWE Hall of Famers, the likes of Stone Cold Steve Austin, Shawn Michaels, Bret Hart.
Oh, I want a lot for Christmas. I don't care about the presents underneath the Christmas tree. I just want you for my own, more than you could ever know. Make my wish come true.
prestigious titles in all of sports entertainment.
On a flying forearm smash.
system.
Yeah.
the price to pay. Time for you to get down on your knees. I pray
you can
say goodbye to the good old days. They're never coming back. Watch if you
I pray.
superstars have been too, though I'm willing to bet one of them will have changed their tune after it's over.
Impressive pinning combinations and devastating submissions will not result in victory in this one. It's just going to come to
Rusty chains of prison wounds are shattered by the sun. My long road horizons change, the tournament's begun. The purple piper plays his tune, the choir softly sing. Melodies in an ancient tongue for the court of the crimson.
I've come to make an announcement. Bruno Bucciarati is a bitch-ass motherfucker. He stole my fucking daughter. That's right, he and his friend, Giorno Giovanna, took their fucking stands out and they rescued my fucking daughter. And they said their resolve was this big. And I said, fate chose me, not them. So I'm making a call-out post on Passion.com. Bruno Bucciarati, you've got a shitty stand. It's as shitty as Survivor, except way worse. And guess what? Here's what my stand looks like. That's right, baby. All power, no weaknesses. Look at that, it looks like a giant ham in fishnets. Here is my eternal climax. So guess what? I'm gonna erase part 6. That's right, this is what you get, my Super Requiem Skip. Except I'm not just gonna skip part 6, I'm gonna go higher. I'm skipping part 7. How do you like that, Araki? I skipped part 7, you idiot! You have 24 years before Jojolion reaches its fucking conclusion. Now get out of my fucking court, before the Crimson King fists you too.
Should be interesting, guys, as six of WWE's top names square off here. That is a great reversal. Boom, running STO plants him.
Nicely done. Darts. Welcome to my castle. We'll be right back.
with the...
Yeah.
something big planned.
Thank you.
contest is a submission match. Making his way to the ring, representing the Social Outcasts from parts unknown. Weighing in at 240 pounds, Eric Extreme.
Guys, this match is sure to not disappoint, especially considering who's involved here tonight.
You're absolutely right, Michael. This match will be one we'll be talking about for a long time to come.
Well, the good news for him, guys, is that he's so egotistical that he likely doesn't even realize how these people feel about him.
No kidding, Michael. Talk about living in your own little world. It must be nice to be convinced that you're the absolute best there is, period.
Huntington Beach, California, weighing in at 282 pounds,
Bye.
trampling. Call your friends, let us. We'll be right back.
time of strength. Ain't nobody man enough to feel the pain. And you can be next. You better give respect. Cause ain't nobody breaking this redneck. Some country boys working overtime, boys. Kings of the South, we never had nothing. Blue collar boys do it with our hands muddy.
Every hair in place, everyone loves this gorgeous face. You can't deny my beauty shot on everything that you are not.
Yeah. Hey, no hands. them right here. You come out here, run to your mouth. There, you and your punk ass friend, Big Daddy Cool, the Rock cast, more like Big Daddy Bitch.
Evading possible disaster there.
Look at this.
Not again.
One of these guys is eventually going to have to get
and I bring you
fire.
You know you've been living so bad.
your grass. Take the moonlight by the tether any side, just shut it. What is there? It's just the same. What is trying your crown? I'm spanning my grass, walking back so where my grass shall fall.